What is up, guys? I'm with The Walking Journey. The link to his channel will be in the description box below. Please subscribe. So we are at the Joe Byrd Cemetery. We are here in Huntsville, Texas. If you can see, there's quite a few graves, over 3,000. These are the graves of people who have died in the prison system here in Huntsville, Texas. And all these people that are here are basically bodies that the families didn't claim. If you look over here, these are very, very old graves. These are graves of prisoners who've done time in the early 1900s, even the late 1800s. This cemetery was named after Joe Byrd. He was the prison warden here in Texas in the late 60s, early 70s. This cemetery was very marsh to land. It was very wooded. He was actually responsible for cleaning up the whole cemetery, reburying prisoners, what have you. And so they named the cemetery after him. He was actually responsible for flipping the switch on the electric chair on almost a dozen men. So there's a cool couple things I want to show you really quick. Also, we're going to go check out the grave of Henry Lee Lucas. In case you guys don't know, Henry Lee Lucas was a bad hombre, as Donald Trump would say, a bad hombre. I'm going to show you a couple other graves of some real scumbags. Real scumbags. So come on, guys, let's go. Come on, Walking Journey, let's go! So this is a little shaded place right here where they have ceremonies for prisoners that die in the prison system here in Huntsville. About 100 prisoners a year die, and they bring them right here to bury. And if you look over here, this is not a grave, but this is a memorial to Chief Stanta. You want to tell everybody about Chief Stanta and who he was?
He was like one of the last Native Americans to fight against the U.S. military.
Yep.
When they were trying to occupy territories from them. I think he's a badass, in my opinion. You might not agree with me. That's real testosterone. He fought to the last.
He was one of the last real men.
Yep.
And even though, you know, we did, in a sense, kind of take this country away from the Native Americans, you know, I'm kind of crossed between that. But this guy, he stood up for his people. He was imprisoned here in Texas. I don't know exactly what the years were. But they claim right there that he died by his own hand. He killed himself.
He killed himself. He refused to serve his sentence.
They buried him here before, but then they moved him to Oklahoma.
In fact, he was in that unit where the prison academy's at that I was supposed to go to.
Aha, I see. Mm-hmm. So, rest in peace, Chief Santanta.
He's in Oklahoma now.
Fort Sill, Oklahoma. Very good. All right, guys, we're going to go see some graves of some real scumbags. So let's take a walk. Okay, we're standing on, there's nobody buried here, but these are the areas of where prisoners that have already died, but they haven't been buried yet. They're going to be placed right here. There's still plenty of land. You know, like I said, about 100 prisoners a year die that are buried here if they're not cremated. So
it looks creepy, Lamont. Look at this. It looks like hell.
This guy died. This guy was born in 1942, died in 2018. So Donald Ray Dixon. Donald Ray Dixon, step right up. You are the next contestant on The Price is Wrong. Yeah. This is kind of creepy.
It's kind of creepy over here.
No, this part looks creepy. Look at this part right here, man. It's
look at all that.
Or anything.
Yeah, they're that is weird.
Imagine some flames over it. It would look like.
So this guy's stone was knocked over here. Pluck it up. I don't know what you did, sir, but listen, no hard feelings, all right? I fixed your grave. I don't want it to... I don't want you to haunt me, all right? So you don't really see this often, but it looks like the family members paid for a stone for this guy. So if you see, that's Pedro Zamora. That number below, that's his inmate number. He was about 47 years old when he died. So you don't see a lot of people bringing flowers. And if you look at the etching on the stones, these are newer. So it looks like they have a machine now to do it. Versus when we're going to show you the older stones over there, they were done by hand. I don't know what this guy did to somebody, but they did not like him. They desecrated his grave. They split it in half. Billy Harper. Not sure what you did, buddy, but I'm sure you deserved it. All right. All right, so we got our first fucking scumbag of the tour right here. So this is Derrick O'Brien. If there is a person that needed to be executed that existed, it's this mofo right here. This guy, back in the 90s, him and his friends, they were hanging around, you know, drinking and doing whatever. And long story short, two women had passed by them, and him and five of his friends brutally gang-raped and murdered two teenage girls. I believe it was in Laredo. I'm not sure. But I will put a link into the description of the story of this clown right here. He was executed on the 11th of July of 2006. In my personal opinion, he's a scumbag and he deserved what he got. It was a very, very heinous, brutal crime that he committed.
Well, look at this. I don't know if you noticed this.
There's a crack right there.
Oh, look. Flip that over.
666.
No coincidence.
Mr. O'Brien, fuck you. All right, so here we have Henry Lee Lucas. He died on March 12th of 2001. He was actually sentenced to death. They did charge him with almost a dozen murders, but George W. Devil Bush Jr. commuted his sentence to life after a bunch of his claims of murdering women with unsolved cases. He commuted his sentence because it was never really known how many people exactly he killed. On the record, he's killed 11. He's claimed to have killed hundreds. Him and his partner, Otis O'Toole, they went around the country just raping and killing. This guy was a rapist. He was a pedophile. Just an overall scumbag. If anybody's burning in hell, it's this guy right here, Henry Lucas. In case you guys want to come out here to check out his grave, it's going to say online that his grave is unmarked because people have came by to vandalize it. As you can see, it's been broken before and repaired. And no, his grave is marked. He's right here. He is right here at the Joe Byrd Cemetery here in Huntsville, Texas. This guy is responsible for killing lots and lots of women. He's a cross-eyed nerd as far as I'm concerned. Okay, guys, so that was a quick tour of the cemetery, Joe Byrd Cemetery here in Huntsville, Texas. Guys, this is my bird feeder. If you pass through Huntsville, Texas, please refill it for me. And that is a walking journey.
Comment, rate, subscribe, walking journey.
Comment, rate, and subscribe, please. The link to his channel will be in the description box below.
Well, I'll be doing some behind the scenes of everything we did today also.
Exactly. So with that being said, we're done here, and I'm Black Bigot, and that's just the way I see it. Is that a good ending thing?
Yeah, I don't know. It's beautiful, man. That's poetic.
Very good. All right, I'm out of here. Later.
Jesus loves you.
He does.